matchup. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis ready to go in the booth. We hope you're ready to go at the controls. Let's play.
Short kick from the 14 and taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Namath to throw on first down. He'll get this to his tight end. That's Pat Freiermuth. Touchdown, LA! Pat Freiermuth, 79 yards. And the Rams are going to take a first quarter lead. One play in the end zone on the long touchdown pass. You knew they wanted to get him involved. He's their go-to guy. First play, though, wow.
Yeah, and I remember when I was playing, something similar happened. I remember getting to the sideline, and my coach said, so what did a scouting report with circling him, putting a star by him? Did you not guess that he was a good player? And that's the question I would have for them now. You know, as you said, he's a go-to guy. How is he not covered? Now, I should say, covered well.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. A play fake, and now Herbert to throw. He's got his man. It's White. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Play action this time for Justin Herbert. They'll roll him out right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
Herbert's throw there complete to Myers. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. Here's the Rams' second all-time leading rusher, Eric Dickerson. And he will have a Chiefs first down, and he's going to have it by plenty. Able to get 8 yards there on third and two. On first down, it's Herbert. And this one almost intercepted. Not a good throw there. Nearly an opening drive, INT. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Justin Herbert looking to pass. And he slings one that's incomplete.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit two of his first five passes with a big third down coming up. He's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
And he stopped up short of the first as they tackle him down at about the 36. It's a 6-yard gain, and it leaves him looking at a fourth down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Here we go on fourth. Herbert. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. Herbert operating from the red zone. That's caught left side to tight end Pitts. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. Herbert. And it's caught.
Well, Brandon, obviously no panic in them. They gave up the touchdown. Yeah, their defensive side did that. But he's already taken them back downfield. I love this field general that they've got it.
And he's going to take it into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Eric Dickerson, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Here's Namath. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now Namath to throw. Getting this into the hands of Eric Dickerson. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay game.
So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 48-yard line. Namath now from the gun. And he'll just get rid of it.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second and 10. Throwing is Namath. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 33.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. To the ground, this time Cook. Then he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Credited with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up, it's 7. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A 2-minute drill before the coaches' 2-minute drill.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. And that's good for a gain of 6. And just like that, it's third down. A play fake. Now Namath. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down.
Now here's a defensive timeout called by the Chiefs. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Off the draw, it's Dickerson. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. Namath. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
But we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he's standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. Buying time to his left. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. So now the Rams send out the field goal team here. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Gay's kick is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So a good kick there. They put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the throw.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either
not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
No run back here for Jones. A touchback. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And with them trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get into field goal range. Now he's going to go deep down the left side. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And the Rams are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield.
Well, I tell you, you can't fault the pass protection here. He had all day to throw, and he just couldn't find anywhere to go with the football. And quarterbacks will tell you that after a while, they start getting antsy back there. So this is just a great job defensively to stay with these receivers as long as they did.
On first and 10 now, Namath. Trying to get it to Robinson, and it's intercepted. Tre'Davious White with a pick. And he will take this all the way down to the 38-yard line.
Certainly feels like the classic second guess, but let's be honest about it. They had a chance going to halftime with the lead. Why did they take a chance with a throw there? I don't understand that.
Well, that's what I'm wondering. And now this defense has to try to protect that lead going into the locker room. Looking there for Pitts, but intercepted. Picked off near the 26.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. On second and very short, Namath. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. First and 10. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. To throw, Namath. He's going to take a shot at the end zone. Why not? And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Keanu Neal. And he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half.
Dang, man, I guess we're looking at the wrong side right here.
And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3. It'll be the Chiefs football to begin quarter number 3, and they trail here as we are back underway now on EA Sports. Here's Jones to bring it out of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people would think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
A good action to this point in the third quarter. Just a three-point game, second and 10. Back to throw here, Herbert. Herbert has it knocked free. And this will be gathered up in the end zone. And that's a defensive touchdown. This was a close game. They needed a little breathing room, or they got it right there on that return for a touchdown.
Yeah, we would say that this could be huge. Forget it. It was huge. Gave him a comfortable lead.
Extra point by Gain is up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. Here's Jones to bring it out of the end zone. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And they weren't on the sidelines for long, but I'll tell you what, I'm glad you and I weren't down there. We could hear the coaches from all the way up here. They were adamant, you've got to hold on to the football or else we have no hope.
Yeah, it's easy for me to laugh sitting up here, but you're exactly right. If we were down there, that message would have been received a whole different way. Because turnovers, they've been a big problem for them. Got to take care of the football. Got to hold on to it.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They'll run on first down. Dickerson. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it.
And the Rams got it. They bring him down. Bobby Brown. What a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive.
On Herbert, his third interception. Picked off at the 36. So an opening drive interception to begin this second half.
And just think about the time you spent in the locker room going over what you expected to do in the second half. Not the way they saw it, not the way they drew it up. You find out this is something that you can't just edit, right? There's no rewrite here. This is live, and now they've got to find a way out of this hole.
Now a dump off here complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line.
Now we get into the psychology of the whole thing because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try to put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Grady Jarrett with the tackle. Here's second and 9. To throw is Namath. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. And they finally catch up to him and take him down. Jeez, where was he going? A huge loss there. And the Chiefs are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Back to Dickerson here on second down. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Three quarters have come and gone. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports.
Herbert setting up to throw on first down. He's got his pass catching tight end. That's Pitts. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
Second and six.
Out of the gun, Herbert. Escaping the pressure right. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. Well, there you go. Save your best scramble of the day for a big-time situation in the fourth quarter, picking up the first.
You don't want to use it up early, right? You want to make sure you save it for that exact moment, that key time. And that's what he did, although you and I both know it wasn't planned that way. But what a nice job using his eyes, scanning the field, and realizing when it was time to exit the pocket and go.
On first down, Justin Herbert. And that is caught. Touchdown, Kansas City. Jacoby Myers there to make the grab. And the Chiefs have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. They went empty backfield, all their weapons out wide, so there really was no secret here to what they were going to do.
No secret, but they still had to execute it, and they still had to protect the guy throwing the ball, because oftentimes when you empty the backfield, people bring pressure at you. They managed to hold in there and successfully complete the touchdown pass.
Anderson on for the extra point. And they're not going to get the kick off in time. That's going to set them back 5 yards. Yeah, slightly more difficult attempt here from the 20. And this is up and good to make it a 17-14 game.
Thanks to the score, Rams 17, Chiefs 14.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. One score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping to you on the other side of the ball, saying, hey, we picked off the last one. What you gonna do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw it with confidence. If there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
Namath to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. On the jet sweep, here comes Jefferson. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
Brings up second and three at the 38-yard line.
3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. On second down, Dickerson. And he's going to have a Rams first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I can be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Daron Harmon makes the tackle.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. Now Namath. Open man, that's the tight end Freiermuth. And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And this defense, they needed that one more stop to have any chance, but that completion, that's likely going to seal their fate.
And you could hear it in your voice, that one more stop.
I feel their pain.
Oh, it was so important. They just didn't get it done. Wow, what a way to finish this one off.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. So the L.A. Rams with a victory here, and they were really helped by their defense, forcing three turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of. But now, it's about taking the ball away, taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had three takeaways in this one.